which is air sign. So this person can have such placements in their moon or rising. This person can be charismatic. They can want leadership. They want to take first, you know, they want to take decisions basically in relationship or in friendship. And this person does not think so much from their emotional side. They are more into their head space, and they can be very lustful as well. Now, that's not the main message that I'm getting, that this person is lustful. There can be extreme amount of passion that you are feeling with this person, but it can also be a Pisces or a Scorpio for some of you, because we have High Priestess and the Tower here. The Tower symbolizes Mars energy, so that is Scorpio and Aries. When it comes to your house, somebody is looking away from the house to something new in their life. They might be ending something in their home, like I don't know what that means, but that's what I'm getting, like something related to their security, their home, their house. They are looking away from it. Now, I'm not saying that this is you, this can be somebody else, mostly a Piscean person. Now, whoever this person is who is looking away from their security, this person probably knows something that nobody else knows. They know, they are quite knowledgeable, and I think this person is also ignoring the fact that there is something crumbling down at home. Now, I don't know what the home symbolizes here, but the word that I'm getting is home. Something is crumbling down at home. Now, amidst all of these things, I'm getting that you have a new start, new commitment that you can have from somebody, or you are making a commitment to a new stability or new foundation. So those were your flippers, Capricorn, and let's see what's the bottom of the energy, deck energy. Overall energy right now is the Two of Wands. Two of Wands is about looking forward to a new start, looking forward to, like, you may be planning about how can I move further than this. I have achieved so much, but how can I move forward to something more, and how can I accomplish that? So I need messages for the sign of Capricorn, Sun, Moon and Rising. Okay, so you have one more flipper here, the Empress card. Some of you can be dealing with a Taurus person as well, or a Libra, mostly a Taurus, because you have it with Mother of Pentacles, which is Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. So this is also telling me that there is a mother here, mother figure, or a maternal figure, or someone who is very feminine. Now, this feminine energy is very comfortable. This can be you, or it can be your partner. This person can be a mother of your child as well. That's the feeling that I'm getting. Now, I'm also getting that you are trying to nurture yourself, or you're trying to nurture something else or somebody around you, someone who is probably younger than you, or a project. You are trying to keep your patience with this entire project. This project can be you as well. If you are on a journey to self-discovery or self-love, or you're just starting to appreciate who you are and how you feel, you are just starting to understand your own beauty, so you are keeping your patience with yourself. One last shuffle for Capricorn, Sun, Moon, Rising for the month of December 2018. Let's see what's coming up for Capricorn. So your okay, so this card comes out again. This card is your heart of the matter now. So let's see what's your this card comes out again. Like I told you when I was doing your reading last time, these two cards were out for you. And I'm not kidding, and this proves it. And I'm freaked out right now. I'm freaked out because these things freak me out. whenever something like this happened, like I was just talking about these two cards and I just told you that they had already come out for you. So they are definitely here talking about something important that is happening in your life, Capricorn. So let's see what are the other cards. Your grounding energy is the very beautiful star card. Then you have the High Priestess, which we already saw in the flippers. This is in your past. Now you have another major arcana. Wow, so you have three major arcanas in a row with one ace card. So this is your lover's card. This is a choice card. You have to make a choice, a commitment. Another major arcana. This is the fourth major arcana in the row. This is in your future, which is the Justice card. Now how you come up in your reading is a very sad card, which is Five of Cups. Your surrounding is Three of Swords. Your hopes and fear is Two of Pentacles. Another major arcana is your outcome. Let's clarify it. Another major arcana clarifying it. So the outcome is the Hierophant with the major arcana Fool clarifying it. I'll pull out another one. Six of Swords. Now Two of Pentacles is clarified by... Okay, so this was also one of the cards that you had received in your previous reading, along with this one. Nine of Swords with Ten of Swords. So it is coming up again in this reading. So we'll definitely focus on that a little bit. And then this is another major arcana clarifying your outside. Another major arcana. So a lot of major arcanas here. We'll see. I'm just okay. So devil is also, so this is you basically. You are choosing you. Definitely you are choosing you. You are wanting to choose you. You're definitely turning your back towards someone. Like you are not engaging with someone that you were dealing with in the month of December. You are leaving this person behind. There is a three-party situation and one of this card. So overall energy is that you are stalking somebody or somebody is stalking you. This person is either doing a research on you. The energies can go vice versa, so just take your messages as they may apply. So somebody is stalking here. I don't know who, but somebody is stalking. It's you or the other person. Now somebody who is around you, or the situation that you probably are dealing with, or the person that you are dealing with, they might be in a three-party situation, or they are going through a heartbreak themselves. But this person is trying to keep their patience, or this person can be a Sagittarius or a Leo. This person, or you are trying to keep your patience with this person, or you are advised to keep your patience with this situation. Probably this thing once upon a time gave you a lot of happiness, or this person is moving towards happiness slowly. Now that's the environment energy. How you come up in your reading is as the Five of Cups. So you might be crying about something that happened in the past, something that is over, something that you have lost, something that cannot be recovered. You are regretting it, or you feel guilty about wasting your time or something like that. Now people are seeing you like that, or you see yourself like that. It's clarified by two cards, which are Eight of Wands and the Nine of Wands. Eight of Wands with Nine of Wands. So there is some burden that you are feeling when it comes to communication. You don't want to communicate about your feeling. You don't want to express to people how you're feeling about your loss. This can be, so you might be sitting alone and grieving this loss, or you just feel on day-to-day basis, or you are traveling right now. And you either you are finding it hard to travel, or you are finding it really hard to fight this battle. But you will, you are going through with this. You have moved from Eight of Wands to the Nine of Wands, so you are taking it forward. You are giving it your last, like you are in the last round. You are in the last lap basically. So you are going to try it once again probably, or you are thinking about if I should or I should not try. Now. Let's see, your hopes and fear here is telling me that you feel that somebody is juggling two people, or you you hope that you will have two jobs that you can juggle efficiently, like you want to balance something, either this is two job or two people, you want to do it really well, like you want to multitask really well. But your fear is that you may not be able to do that, but it may also mean that some of you are feeling that somebody is juggling two people and there is a betrayal that is going on, and there is a lot of competition, and somebody that you are probably dealing with is attracting too many people or are distracted from you, like they are distracted away, they are somewhere else. This can be you as well. Now, what's on your mind is the Lovers with the Devil and the Father of Pentacles and Eight of Cups. This is telling me that you are thinking about making a difficult choice of either leaving somebody behind and choosing yourself, or you are choosing a Gemini person or a Capricorn person or a Earth sign, which is Taurus, Virgo, Sun, Moon, Rising. You will choose one of these person, and or you are just choosing to leave someone behind because you feel that it was waste of your emotions. So it's a very difficult choice that you have to make because it's a major arcana, so you are still thinking about it. In your past energy, I'm getting that you have High Priestess. Something was definitely hidden from you, or somebody knew something secret was going on. Now this person can be all knowing. They were waiting for the answer to come from the other person, but they already knew something. Now this can be you or the other person, but there was somebody working behind the scenes. This person can be a young employee or somebody like an intern or somebody who helps, like someone who is like an assistant to somebody. This person can be in a three-party situation, or this person is your friend, or there are friends that you were dealing with in the past who were gossiping about something. There has been some separation because of that, like there has been something something immature that you were dealing with in the past. It may have led to a ego battle or a bitter. Bitter fight I'm getting, but it's more like exchange of words, like abrupt exchange of word, not a very mature conversation. It feels like immature exchange of words, like blaming somebody, that sort of energy. Now in future, you have the Justice with the Ten of Pentacles and the Sun of Cups. Justice with the Ten of Pentacles and the Sun of Cups is telling me either you are in a situation where you are separating, or there is a balance that is being restored in your family. This is in future, so anything can happen. You might be restoring balance because of a younger person, like a child. You might be restoring balance because of a child or for a child. It can be Libra or a water sign. There is something new, like something passionate that is starting. Or there is a lot of passion and lust, ambition, energy, lot of energy, enthusiasm. But somebody is thinking about something over and over again. Should I do this? Should I not? Should I? What should I do? Why did this happen to me? Should I grab this opportunity? That sort of questioning. And lot of other questions which are killing you, and this is coming up as your challenge. So unless you stop thinking so much and get out of that space, you cannot actually make any move. You cannot actually move any any further. No matter how much energy you have, you cannot do anything with that energy unless you get out of that head space, which is making you feel sick, which is making you feel stuck in a cycle which is redundant. Now, Daughter of Swords with the Six of Pentacles. I'll say that like I said, like this is somebody researching, doing their research about something. Maybe this person is considering what is right, what is wrong, how much am I receiving, how much am I giving. This person is quite logical, so they are acting from their logical brain. They are not in their heart space, they are in their head space. So they want their gains, they don't want to make a lose, you know, they don't want to lose something, they want to make profit or they want to gain something. Now the root of this reading is that there is either an Aquarius person that you're dealing with, or there is some healing going on, or you are focusing on your healing in some way. Now guys, I know this entire reading is all over the place, but you will have to understand that I just convey the messages as I get them. I do not make a story out of them. So it is for you to make a story out of them. If it applies to you, then this reading is for you, or there are some messages which are for you. But not all the messages are for you. So kindly just take what resonates with you and leave the rest. However, this energy is telling me that, let me just be very, very clear here, that entire reading, it's telling me that you are the mature person here, okay? Or there is this earth energy which is very mature. Like it can be Taurus, it can be you, or you have Taurus in your chart. Everybody has every sign, but somebody has a very strong earth energy here, who is coming out as a very mature person in this reading. But you can be dealing with a lot of immature people. I have Daughter of Cups, Daughter of Wands, Son of Cups, Son of Sword, Son of Wands, Daughter of Pentacles, Daughter, Son. These are very immature energies. Although you come up as Father of Pentacles, which is a very stable and grounded energy, somebody very sure about what they are doing. So that's a good thing. Like you are coming up as someone who knows what they are doing. Other people, I don't think so much. Like they are not doing, like they are not acting from a very not acting from a place of awareness. Now when it comes to your root energy, you are trying to heal something, you are trying to protect something, you are trying to be hopeful about something, you are trying to keep your hopes up with regarding either two children or a child, or it's just that you want to take care of somebody, or you're just trying to take care of a child within you. Like you want to treat yourself really well, and you are developing yourself from very beginning, like from the get-go. Like you want to look after yourself in a very nurturing way. Somebody here is trying to listen to other person's emotions as well, or somebody is expressing their emotions in a very sweet way. This person can find you charming, or you are finding this person charming, and you are expressing or telling them that you find them very sweet or something of that nature. Now in future there can be someone who will probably let you know that that's not the message that I'm getting, so I'm not gonna talk about that. But for a very small group, I'm getting that somebody will offer you a new start when it comes to your family situation. Maybe it is after a separation, like you separated from this person, or this is a new person offering to start a family with you or support you. So they will just let you know, they won't make a grand gesture, they will just offer you a emotional support sort of. However, the end of this reading is telling me with the Hierophant that there is a Taurus person or something in a authoritative, like authority. It can be school, family, court, this can be anything, any institution. This can be a guru, or this can be church, anything. you have to make a new start. This is divinely guided. So somebody is probably asking you to do something, but you know that you have to make a new start. There is you trying to revolt. That's what I'm getting here. Like, you are trying to revolt. You want to start something new. You want to start something fresh. I'm also seeing here that somebody is leaving their family because of this entire situation that they were dealing in, because they feel that they have been stuck in a very conventional something, like a very conventional boring thing. Excuse me that I'm saying that, but that's the message that I'm getting. And then they want to move away from a lot of bickering that is happening, a lot of questioning, doubts and difficulty that this person is facing. They want to move away, they want to take risk and move away and start a new journey for themselves, away from all the immaturity that they are facing. Now, overall energy, like I said, is that either you are stalking or this person is stalking. It can be a Leo and it can be at work for some of you. Actually, since it was Major Arcana, I'm gonna say there is definitely a Leo energy there. So it might take you a lot of effort to find some information, is what I'm getting here for some of you. Let's see what is the blockage for the Capricorn for this month of December 2018. Blockage for Capricorn, Sun, Moon, Rising. This was the card that I was seeing. Joy is coming up as a blockage and then rejection. Rejection and joy. So you are trying to have fun, you are trying to enjoy, but that's not happening, or you are just refusing to participate in happy things, and you are refusing to participate in celebrations, which is coming up as blockage. So don't do that. You also have to heal your sacral chakra. So listen to guided meditation regarding sacral chakra, or do a little bit meditation. It is available online. So do sacral chakra meditation probably. And rejection is coming up as blockage. So some of you might be afraid of some sort of rejection that might come your way. And because of that fear, you are not doing something. Maybe you are afraid of gossip. Maybe you are afraid of rejection. So that's why you are not taking certain steps. But my advice is obviously do it for yourself. Whatever you feel in your heart is right thing to do, do that. Don't stop yourself from living your best life that you feel you deserve. So yes, let's see what's one of the messages for Capricorn. You are getting relax the hold of darkness and be at cause. So some of you are definitely dealing with a very difficult situation. You feel very trapped in a situation where you feel a little bit depressed. There is a very there is something hopeful that's something you have created. Like, you have created hope for your own self and you want to take that leap. You are still considering if I can take that leap. You are still thinking about how can I take that leap, how can I move out of this darkness that is around me. So the line here is relax the hold of darkness and be at cause. Now ask yourself, how do you feel? This is very important for you to know. Be sure about what you feel. Don't neglect your feelings, because in this entire reading I did not get a cups card. Like, I just got one cups card, which was coming up as you very unhappy, living in the past, thinking about all the losses that you have faced, all the regrets that you have. But I did not get any other cups card in your reading. So you are definitely some of you not listening to yourself, not paying heed to your feelings. You are ignoring what you feel, and that's not going to serve you really well. So avoid that. And like I said, do work on your sacral chakra. I'm getting that some of you are feeling guilty about something, or you are holding yourself responsible for something which is blocking your joy and happiness. So I'll see you again, Capricorn. I'm not sure if I'll be posting in the year 2019, until unless like I get a good response for the November and the December videos, I don't think I'm going to continue. That's all, I guess. And I went in full speed. I don't know like why that happened, but yeah, take care. I hope that something resonated and was of use to you. See you again someday. I'm really not sure right now if I'll continue, but yeah, if we see each other, then I'll tell you I'm here. But for now, Happy New Year. Enjoy your 2019 and see ya.